Thank you, Mr. Cantu. And now a special treat. This is the school song and chant, and many of us will hear it for the very first time, presented by the Escobar Elementary School Choir under the direction of Mr. Mario Vallejo. I would now like to call on Ms. Diana Ruiz to come back, Administrator for Elementary Schools, for a special presentation.
Aida Escobar Choir, you did a really good job. And I think the children are going to continue singing this song and they're going to enjoy it too because it has a good ending. At this time, in order to provide you with a peek of the tremendous impact that Mrs. Escobar has had on this community, we have developed a video that will highlight her life, her work, and her numerous accomplishments, not only during her tenure at PSJA, but also after her retirement as she continues to serve the community. Please turn your attention to the video and enjoy it.
Ask people about retired PSJA educator Aida Escobar, and a wealth of positive words are used to describe her.
Devoted, awesome, trendsetter, hard worker,
inspirational.
The San Juan native served at PSJA ISD for 43 years, touching the lives of countless students and employees. For more than four decades, she brought her tireless spirit and abundant knowledge to the Tri-Cities, benefiting the children of PSJA. With the motto of students today, graduates tomorrow, and leaders forever, Aida C. Escobar Elementary School honors a leader in the field of education. Born on January 22, 1942, to Jose Refugio and Beatriz Cano, Aida, the eldest of three children, learned the meaning of hard work at an early age from her parents. She and her siblings helped out at the family-owned grocery store after school and on the weekends. In the summer, while other children spent their days playing outdoors, she attended summer school to advance in her studies. Her dedication paid off, and in 1958, she graduated from PSJA High School at just 16 years old.
Education was very important to both of them, and that is why they kept sending us to school. We never missed school. We had perfect attendance because he didn't want us to miss a day of school.
Knowing the value of a solid education, Aida wasted no time in earning her bachelor's degree in education from Pan American College. She graduated in 1961, 3 years after finishing high school. It was a time of new beginnings in her life. That December, she married her college sweetheart, Ricardo Escobar, She also started her teaching career at Ford Elementary School as a second grade teacher. She was 19 years old. From the moment she entered the school, she left a lasting impression.
The first experience I had with her was seeing her walk the halls of the school. And I thought, not only is she beautiful, she looks like she's in command and she knows what she's doing. Such confidence.
She was very professional. She always looks very professional. And she was very energetic. She, you know, moved quickly from one situation to another and tried to take care of things as they came.
For 10 years, she guided the students that entered her classroom. She worked hard to achieve student success in a time of many changes to education, serving as a role model for both students and staff. Her unwavering commitment did not go unnoticed, and in 1971, then Superintendent of Schools Gus Guetta named her the district's bilingual supervisor and curriculum writer. Aida pioneered the district's introduction of the bilingual program. Not an easy task, since speaking Spanish had previously not been allowed in the classroom.
I was not allowed to speak Spanish at school, and neither were the children. I remember one time I had a child who didn't understand a word of English. So I was teaching this lesson, and it involved the word oatmeal. And I went out to the hallway to see if anybody was coming, rushed back in, and taught the word avena.
Bilingual education had just come into the forefront as a state law. And so implementation, and of course, you know, the demographics of PSJA were that there were a lot of children whose first language was not English. So there we were inventing as we were going along, and she was a pioneer, she was a leader, and she was not afraid to take the risks, even though we didn't know what was going to come out at the end. But she was visionary, and she was willing to do the work that it took.
She held that position until 1976, when she took on the role of assistant principal at Ford Elementary. During these years, she balanced being a devoted educator and loving mother to her two children, Rick and Cindy. And she still managed to earn her master's degree in elementary education supervision and mid-management certification in 1977. That year, she was selected as the principal of Longoria Elementary School in FAR. She would lead the school for 10 years. In her role as campus administrator, Aida had high expectations for the school, the students, and her staff.
Aida was always very professional, and I really had to prepare for my lessons. So being the leader that she was and the teacher that she was, you know, I really started off with a very solid and sound foundation in teaching and love to teach because of her.
Of all the principals I've ever worked with, and I've worked with hundreds and hundreds of principals throughout the country, she was, I think, by far number one. She had a grasp of curriculum and methodology and was able to inspire her teachers to go in that direction and work very diligently to provide the best education for her students.
Her drive and ability to inspire others brought success for Aida and PSJA ISD. Throughout her career, she earned several recognitions, from having Longoria Elementary School recognized as an exemplary school by the U.S. Department of Education and President Ronald Reagan, to receiving the Educator of the Year Award twice from the FAR Chamber of Commerce, to also being honored with the JCPenney Spirit of the American Women Award.
She was so hardworking, so dedicated, so devoted to what her life was all about, and that was to help kids.
She continued to advance in her career. In 1987, she rose up the ranks of school administration to administrator for elementary education. And in 1990, she became assistant superintendent of curriculum and instruction. A trailblazer, Aida was the first female assistant principal, the first Mexican-American female principal, and the first female assistant superintendent at PSJA ISD. She mentored and encouraged other Hispanic women to follow in her footsteps.
That was at a time when women were beginning to find their place in administrative roles, and she was one of those for us. She was that example here. that she was not just good in the classroom, she was just not good as a school principal, which some women had already had taken that role, but central office administration. Now that was a whole different level. And we all then began to aspire for that.
When we were colleagues, she always shared the good things that she was doing at her school, and then she mentored me and helped me avoid some of the pitfalls that I needed to avoid. So I really appreciated her advice and wisdom.
After 43 years of exceptional service and an unyielding dedication to student success, Aida retired on June 24th, 2004.
Yes, I have a life of 43 years with PSJA at PSJA. More years than with my parents, more years than even with my own family. So it was a very hard decision for me to make. And people kept trying to convince me that there is life after PSJA. So the new chapter in my life, I'm going to look for that life after PSJA.
Ever the tireless and giving spirit, she continues to contribute to the community with volunteer work at various organizations, including Driscoll Children's Hospital, Hidalgo County, and the city of Far. Given her exemplary commitment to education and community service, naming a school after her is a fitting tribute.
I remember the phone call. I got a phone call early in the morning, and Mijita, guess what? Oh, I could just hear it in her voice. They named a school after me. And mother, I said, we kind of had a feeling, but it finally came true. I said, well, Mom, you know, you deserve it. If there's anybody in this community that deserves a school, it's you.
The first day of school, I called the office here, and I wanted to see how they greeted the people on the phone. And sure enough, they said Escobar Elementary. So that confirmed that it was indeed true that it was named after me. But it's such an honor. It is something that I still can't believe.
Escobar Elementary School is located at 901 West Kelly Street in Far and is home to the Bobcats. It opened its doors in August 2012 to more than 800 students. The school is committed to achieving immediate and future success at the pre-K through fifth grade levels.
This building, it is so beautiful. I think it's the most beautiful building in the district. Not that I'm biased or anything, but I think they have this opportunity to learn better in this type of environment. They have good teachers, and they have all the opportunities children can only dream of in other parts of the world. So they should take advantage of the learning situations they have in this school.
It's a place that serves the students of today and graduates of tomorrow. And it honors Aida Escobar, a trusted role model, mentor, trailblazer, and leader forever.
Once a Bobcat, always a Bobcat. Long live the Bobcat. Hoo!
We also have an honored guest here who would like to say some words about Aida. I'd like to call now up to the podium Dr. George Gonzalez, former professor at UTPA and education consultant.
Dr. King, superintendent, board members, city commissioners, Mr. Mayor, parents, students, friends, good morning. We are gathered here today to honor the outstanding achievements of Aida Escobar as an exemplary educator at all the levels, teacher, principal, and assistant superintendent. She has truly demonstrated the knowledge and skills that are fundamental in the competencies of a great leader and educator. To lead a school or school district successfully requires knowledge and skills related to the instructional process and how children learn. Around her work, along with the ability to organize and guide others around her work collaboratively toward a unifying and well-defined mission, while keeping short-term and long-term goals in mind, balancing these goals and strategies within a complicated work schedule requires a set of very positive attributes. These attributes are passion, vision, and determination. Aida Escobar's passion was deep-seated and inspirational. It was clear by interacting with her that she was strong in her devotion to children and their progress in the classroom and beyond the school. Those of us who worked with her were easily motivated by her devotion to the task of providing the best educational opportunities for children. Her vision was based on a clear picture of a comprehensive, systematic, and deliberate educational program that reflected local PSJA needs as well as the requirements of a state-mandated set of objectives and concerns. In addition to passion and vision, Aida Escobar demonstrated a sense of determination. She enlisted all sorts of resources available to her and her staff and provided an environment conducive to meet the desired goals. This environment always included a warm and pleasant setting, materials and supplies, purposeful supervision, and snacks, especially taquitos. With these personal motivation factors, passion, vision, and determination, Mrs. Escobar and the Longoria Elementary School embarked on a series of programs designed to assist students who were not succeeding on grade level due to a lack of English language skills. Bilingual education focused on English as a second language, along with las artes del lenguaje en español. Materials were developed, strategies were defined, and teachers and teacher aides were trained under the leadership of the principal, Mrs. Aida Escobar. In order to describe the tireless efforts required to create the environment for success, allow me to offer one example of one of the projects we developed. The English Language Development Program, or ELDP, called for coloring book pictures to represent the vocabulary to be taught in grades kindergarten, first, second, and third. A group of teachers worked diligently during the summer at Longoria Elementary School to identify 3,000 pictures that depicted the concepts in the reading program through the third grade in context. For example, let me give you one example. There were many abstract concepts to be learned by Spanish-speaking kids in English. There was the concept even. Elephant was easy, alligator was easy, we could teach dinosaur, but even is quite abstract and difficult to understand if you're a young Spanish-speaking child who is learning to speak English. So we found a picture of grandma on a fast-spinning merry-go-round. And we assigned it the sentence, even grandma is on the merry-go-round. Thus, we matched the concepts to the pictures. When we were Spanish-speaking children in McAllen, 100 years ago, talk about me, we didn't know how to say merry-go-round, so we called it La Ochingway. La Ochingway. It was years later, working on my PhD, when I realized it's called the Ocean Wave Bato. But for years, everybody called it La Ochingway. So we matched 3,000 concepts to 3,000 pictures. It took a while. Audio tapes of all the stories, in the reading programs in English and Spanish were prepared in the district's studio. These materials, pictures and audio tapes, were replicated and distributed. Guides and manuals were written, and teachers and teacher aides were trained. The ELDP program was only one of many efforts supervised by Mrs. Aida Escobar. There were many other initiatives undertaken under her leadership as principal. Aida Escobar wanted to build a cohesive, knowledgeable, and innovative faculty and staff who was dedicated to working long hours to achieve a high-level functioning student body. So she organized an ongoing in-service program at her school to bring about an exemplary level of teaching learning competency. Even the 40-minute period before the start of the day, of the school day, was employed for a very targeted teacher training objective. Soon the academic results at Longoria Elementary School depicted significant and outstanding measurable progress in the bilingual areas of study. As a result, the school received many accolades and awards at the local, state, and national levels. There grew a spirit of excellence and unity that I, as a university teacher trainer, had never witnessed and have not seen on the many other campuses that I have visited. The same spirit of excellence and unity was moved to a larger field upon Mrs. Escobar's promotion to assistant superintendent of the PSJA school district. Her quest for answers to enhance educational opportunities for all the students now had a larger audience, and her responsibility grew. It was met with equal determination and vision. In attempting to list a few of the many salient accomplishments in a life dedicated to the education of PSJA students, the following can be cited. First, elementary teacher at Napper Elementary School, bilingual supervisor and curriculum writer, assistant principal at Henry Ford Elementary School, principal at Longoria Elementary School. Here's where Longoria was recognized by the U.S. Department of Education as an exemplary blue ribbon school and the number one school in the state of Texas. Administrator for elementary education and then assistant superintendent. She was recognized by the Chamber of Commerce, the Texas Council of Women School Executives, the White House under President Reagan, TEA, the Hosts Program, the Texas Monthly Magazine, J.C. Penney, etc., etc., etc. May the legacy of the work and accomplishments of our honored educator, Mrs. Aida Escobar, live on in this, her designated school, and may the many students occupying these classrooms now and in the future follow in her path toward an exemplary education, recognizing her as their inspiration and their model. Thank you. And now I have the distinct pleasure to introduce to you our honored and exemplary educator, Mrs. Aida Escobar.
Thank you.